Good day everyone, I'm Sarah Peace. For today, I will show you on how to measure liquid and dry ingredients. So, in dry ingredients, I prepare white sugar, brown sugar, and flour. In liquid ingredients, we have vanilla and water. So, in measuring a liquid and dry ingredients, we need these tools and equipment. Here, we have graduated measuring cup. We have spatula, stainless spatula. If you don't have this tool, you may use a flat surface of a spoon or a knife. Next is the measuring cups and measuring spoon. So, we have two kinds of measuring cups. We will measure a liquid ingredient. So first, this is a water. So we can use this graduated measuring cup. And using this, we can stay it in a flat surface. Then pour a liquid. And measure it with an eye level. So here is the water. Next is the vanilla. In measuring a vanilla, we can use a measuring spoon. So I use 1/4 teaspoon. A dry ingredients. First, we will measure is the flour. Flour is the main or commonly basic ingredients in baking. So, in measuring a flour, if the recipe is needed a sifted flour, you may sift the flour first before you measure. So, for this task, I don't have spoon here, so may I use this another measuring cup. Don't scoop this measuring cup in flour. Then, use this stainless spatula and blend it. Next, we will measure your white sugar. Measuring a brown sugar, this is a different kind of method in measuring. So in measuring a brown sugar, it's a different kind of method. So first, you scoop, and then pat. You can put it on a bowl or a plate. So, you will not use the spatula, so just your hand. So that's all in 5 examples of measuring dry and liquid ingredients.
Measuring ingredients.
two liquids and three